Hi kids, today we are going to start with a new lesson, sharing our feelings. After returning home from school, there are two people with whom I like to share all my news. They enjoy listening to my tales. The first person is my Nani, grandmother. She is always anxious to listen to me. Anxious means eager and interested. She waits for me to return from school. She is quite old and often has back pains. She cannot see or hear well. Every day in the morning, Papa, my father, reads the newspaper aloud to her. She does the rest of her work herself. If someone tries to help her, she gets very upset. Though she cannot see properly, she is very fond of cutting vegetables. She says, these days, children do not know how to cut vegetables properly. The second person is my Ravi Bhaiya. He lives with us. I call him Ravi Bhaiya and he calls my parents Bhaiya Babi. I do not know what our relationship is, but he is a very loving brother. He is always ready to answer my questions. He never says, I will tell you later. Ravi Bhaiya teaches in a college. The students of the college respect him a lot. A few of them come home to study from him. Ravi Bhaiya is very fond of listening to music and taking part in plays. He enjoys chatting with his friends and going out with them. He has a good sense of humor and makes all of us laugh. Bhaiya carries a white stick when he goes out. Looking at him moving around in the house, no one can say that he cannot see. He likes to do all his work himself. If someone tries to help him against his wish, he gets angry. Whenever he needs any help, he asks for it. Some of Bhaiya's students take books from him and return them after recording them on tapes. Ravi Bhaiya listens to these tapes. Why do you think Ravi Bhaiya uses a white stick when he goes out? Because Ravi Bhaiya cannot see. When he goes out, he uses his stick to find his way around on the streets. Bhaiya has many other books too. The pages of these books are thick and have rows of raised points, that is dots. He reads by running his fingers on the raised dots. To have fun with Bhaiya, I sometimes change the place of his stick. He does get upset but never gets angry. After all, I am his favorite sister, Seema. I had hardly reached the door that Bhaiya spoke up. Seema, you seem to be very happy today. Bhaiya recognizes not only me but all the other family members from the sound we make as we move. He can even tell whether I am happy or sad. How do you think Bhaiya could tell if Seema was happy or sad? Probably from Seema's voice. Bhaiya listens to all the sounds around him and tries to identify the people and the things around him. Bhaiya, finally I am in the football team. I shared my news with him. He patted me and said lovingly, from today, you are my football coach. Football is an outdoor game played with a ball. Let us answer some questions. Seema's father reads the newspaper aloud to her Nani. How do you help old people? Sonu says that I go with my grandfather for his evening walk. What kind of problems do people have in old age? They cannot see, hear, or walk properly in their old age. They become weak. Now ask these questions to yourself. Think about the answers for them. Write your own answer in your book. How does Ravi Bhaiya come to know so many things without seeing? He has a very strong sense of hearing, so he can come to know so many things without seeing. Have you ever needed a stick? When? Sita says, no, I have never needed a stick. Can you think when you may need a stick? Sita says, I would need a stick when I hurt my leg and cannot walk. How do we help those people who cannot see? Sita says, I help them when they want to cross the roads or climb the stairs. Now, ask these questions to yourself and think about the answer. Write your own answer in your book. Is there any member in your family who cannot see, speak, or hear? Do you know any such person? How do people help them with their work? Sonu says, no, there is no such person in my family. Now ask this question to yourself. Think about the answer and write your own answer in your book. You read in the story that Ravi Bhaiya cannot see, but he does all his work on his own. He studies from a different kind of books. Let's see what they are. With this, we come to the end of this lesson. In this lesson, we saw how people who cannot see have a sharp sense of hearing.